Holder Eddie.
Hi, name's Jesse Ramirez.
And today we'll be presenting to you our senior technical project, which is a motorcycle trailer.
So, based off of the senior project, it was to ultimately design and build a trailer that was capable of hauling a motorcycle, specifically a Suzuki, as well as registering and having the trailer inspected and to be able to tow it down the road legally with the vehicle.
So why did we choose this project? It's past semester, very excited to say, finally got my own motorcycle. Last summer I got my license and last semester got the motorcycle. It is a 2005 Suzuki SV650, low mileages, always a bonus, excited about that. It weighs 430 pounds wet weight, so fuel in the tank, you know, all the brake lines filled, everything like that. Weighs 430 pounds riding down the road. I have no way of towing it place to place, which is why we designed and built a motorcycle trailer. If I were to break down, have a mechanical issue, maybe a little accident, need to tow it home, or maybe my friends want to go out for a ride and I don't want to ride the bike to the location, building a trailer would give us the option to tow it there. And we also wanted to get the best of both worlds and make the trailer very versatile, as you can't ride a motorcycle all seasons, as you know. So we wanted to combine a motorcycle trailer and a utility trailer in one and get the best of both worlds.
So how we started. So one of the first steps for the process of building this trailer was to start designing. We started performing some calculations for the chosen frame design, and if something didn't work out, we made the necessary changes. We basically placed in ordered parts, fabrication processes, and looked into our final steps on stating the trailer.
So our first steps, after we had the idea of what we wanted in our head, taking the basis of a utility trailer, we started with the first model, which is shown here up top. We decided to run a C-channel wide enough for the bike tires to fit into up the middle. And then when you strap the bike down, this gives us a little extra stability so the bike won't fall over. From there, we went to our second design, which we needed to change the base frame for to be more compatible with the suspension that we chose for the project. This added a little more weight, a little more cost, and a little more material, but all in all, it made the structure much more robust and sound, so we were okay with that. Our third and last design is shown here on the bottom. We made a couple changes here. We added these angle side pieces to support any side loading and make the trailer more stable, especially if you have an uneven load on there to tow. We placed the vertical C-channel back a little bit. This brought the weight of the motorcycle back more towards the axle and lightened up the tongue weight, as this trailer is a Class A rating, which means a 2,000 pound load and 200 pound tongue weight. So us moving the C-channel back allowed the bike weight to be moved back and lighten up the tongue weight. It also allowed for a little more room up front there for us to add a spare tire or a utility box or a winch or whatever is you want to mount, we have a little more room to work there. And our last change was moving these little side pieces, the mounts for the lights. They were in the back, but we decided to move them forward, that way in case you're rear-ended or you back into something, gives the lights a little more protection, that way they won't be the first things to break.
So like I said before, during the design processes, calculations are a notion to be stated. As you can see from the slide, these are one of examples of calculations that were used to basically state if the trailer is structurally sound, such as the tongue weight slash axle placement, welding calculations, lifting load calculations, and bolting calculations.
So the program we used, SolidWorks, allowed us to create those renderings and assemblies so we could see how the trailer would look before fabrication. It's a very versatile program, software, and allows us to perform FEA, which is finite element analysis. This is where we can look at the deformation of structural members based on a specific loading that we apply in the software and determine if that structural member is adequate to continue with for fabrication. This top slide here, top picture, shows one of the cross members of the base frame of the trailer. It's 56 inches long, fully fixed at both ends with welds all the way around. And we decided to take the maximum weight that the trailer could hold, 2,000 pounds, and apply it at the very middle. This is worst case scenario, as any weight on the trailer will be displaced across all of the members. So we wanted to take a look at the worst scenario and see what the beam would do. So with that 2,000 pound loading, we had a max displacement in the middle of the beam of just over a 1/16 of an inch. And this showed us that the wall thickness that we chose, which is a 1/4 inch, makes for a heavy trailer, but very structurally sound and robust, could handle the load that we could apply to it. This bottom picture here shows another analysis, an FEA, of one of those 8-foot long wooden runners of the trailer. Here we placed a 200 pound load evenly across the entire area, the top surface, fully fixed at both ends. Again, this is worst case scenario, as there are multiple cross members running underneath each wooden runner, the base frame pieces, and will give you support throughout the piece, not just at the ends. Even then, the trailer had the wooden runner had less than 1/8 of an inch displacement, showing that a loading can be displaced across all the pieces, and we're allowed to use them.
And while SOLIDWORKS basically states FEA simulations, it can also portray a bill of materials and also a cost analysis. So within the cost analysis, it basically racked up to at least $756.87. And while looking at the bill of materials, it was all custom made too.
This purchase price may seem like a lot, especially for college kids, we know. But this is how much we spent on the trailer, but it's actually very comparable to trailers of similar size. Our trailer is 8 feet long and 5 feet wide. Like I stated earlier, 2,000 pound load, 200 pound ton weight. And if you want a trailer that size, that's this structurally sound, this robust, you're gonna end up paying over $1,200, between $1,200 and $1,300 for a like trailer. So this actually isn't too bad, and we get to make it. So after we decided the cost analysis and we got the bill of materials and we ordered all the parts, we started then with fabrication. We started with the base frame, which are the perimeter pieces, 5 feet by 8 feet, the cross members that are in there, and that vertical C-channel that runs up the middle. From there, we went on to the pieces on the bottom of the trailer that the coupler is attached to, the tongue, the side pieces that we added in on the third design. Then we flipped it over and added the uprights for the railing, and the railings across the sides and across the top. From there, flipped it back over, went on to suspension and running gear. And then after that was all welded on, pretty much the trailer was complete except for priming and painting and adding those wooden pieces, as far as all the metal work goes. After those wooden runners were added, we added the lights to the trailer, ensured that they worked, and the last two there are work that we had to do on my car as well. So we needed to add a wiring harness so we can tow the trailer, and needed to have add a receiver to tow the trailer as well.
So within the fabrication process, we leveled up everything, starting with the base frame, connected these points with weld, placed in the C-channel. Then afterwards, we went down to the side railings, actually turned it around, that wasn't fun, and also placed in the vertical C-channel and the tongue.
From there, we went on to adding the suspension and running gear of the trailer. This process took quite a long time, like the first step here shown, because we needed to triangulate all the measurements because we don't want the trailer towing sideways. You know, we want it to follow the car or truck or whatever vehicle is towing it perfectly. We don't want uneven wear on the tires. We wanted to do this process very thoroughly and make sure it was all correct. After that was added, we were able to add the wooden runners and the lights. The trailer really started coming along then. The final steps were, after we finished all the wooden runners, the trailer needed to go in for registration and inspection. This included weighing the trailer, 660 pounds, which was somewhat heavy, but like I said, a very robust design. We used some thicker material, but trailer will never break, so that's nice. Registration and inspection on the trailer are complete, as of very recently, and the motorcycle as well. So this week, for the student showcase, we'll bring up the trailer with the bike mounted to it and show you guys what we made. Thank you.
Thank you.